2020 March, things tracked in India and globally in the month of Jan. What really happened? These five fingers that opened to different world was confined inside your palm, inside homes. Artists, more artists of different sector, people locked up in rooms, no work, live shows got canceled, and everything was just at pause. What did you do? That's when a thought came in. Maybe just one day at a time. One day at a time is life's only rhyme. Just one day at a time. And I'm saying this musically because the artists who believed in it and they're going about it. It's now time to hear more from the artist who witnessed it, who's sailing through, and who will tell you a true story of their own, the mapping the impact of pandemic on music artists. Very delighted with ears wide open. I request you all to please listen to every artist because they are going to bring about that very important story that you may connect to, that you should connect to, and you will connect to. Welcoming a set of speakers who will join us. Very, very happy and delighted to welcome wellness and leadership practitioner Sunita Bhuyan. Joining her is going to be Indian classical vocalist for Tumri in her forte, Dhanashree Pandit Rai. Joining the two is going to be chief executive for Showcase Events, session chair also, Nani Singh. And joining them is Danish Hussain, the Hoshruba repertory. And along with them is the journalist, artist, rabab player, Nazir Ganai. Along with them is John Nassar Lone, music director, playback singer, founder, AR Music Studios. And of course, Abha Hanjura, singer, composer, songwriter, live performer, founder, Ziply Productions Recorded Level. I welcome you all this morning to the World Music Day and to the very special Music Inc. 4.0. I know you all are here and are waiting to get the words flowing your way musically. So I first want to quickly go into our session chair. Nani, to you, all the very best. And let's hear more from what's going to be the mapping, the impact of pandemic on music artists. Over to you, Nani.
Thank you, Vithin. Thank you for this opportunity, Ruhail, and the entire team at Exchange for Media and Business World. And it's a pleasure to host this panel today. And like I always tell Ruhail, that I'm happiest being a moderator because as a moderator, I get the opportunity to learn and absorb much more. Speaking and Gyan, you can do anytime, but I definitely want to learn. With such a fantastic panel like today, since we're already spilling out on time, I'm not going to do too much talking. But so our subject line for today, two of our speakers haven't turned on their cameras. So Jan and Nazir, please, if you could have your cameras on so that everybody can see you. Nazir and Jan, please. Okay, so till they join, let's continue. And they're going to be on the thing soon. So today is World Music Day. And as we all know, World Music Day has to have a lot of music. And that's what our panel is all about. We've got perfect artists of all genre, all types, and they're going to present a lot of stuff. So you got a lot of surprises coming in as well. But to definitely talk about the subject that was given to us, which is mapping the impact of the pandemic on the music artists. So we all know that the pandemic has impacted the creative economy immensely. We all know that. We also know a lot how many of the musicians changed their lines of work, their profession. They stopped music despite not knowing anything else, but they stopped music because there was no money coming in. They had to get food on the table. So they changed their profession. They started cooking and they started doing other stuff, which made no sense, but there was no option. As a result of which, we have lost out on a lot of amazing talent in our country. A lot of artists started impromptu and a lot of artists started planned concerts. They moved towards technology. They imbibed technology. And how many of us could do that? That's a whole conversation. I don't even want to get into that because the idea over here is to move everything forward. We've gone through the tragedies that people have been through. So let's move on from here. And taking that forward, Many of them adopted the skills of technology like all of you did. I saw what Abha did, and I saw what Dhanashree did, and Sunita, she transformed a whole room into a house, into a studio. Danish did the same. Nazir has been practicing. And so, you know, everybody has made that effort and done that. So to open the panel, first of all, I just want to start with a short introduction. And when I shoot the question, I will introduce you, and then I will ask you the question, and then we can go on. That will be in the first round only, because I want people to know more about you. So let's start with Nazir. The reason why, because I'm really happy to share that today we are in a situation when we have three artists from the Valley, which has been the toughest call always. So Nazir, of course, everybody knows about you, but I would still like to share a bit about you, because we're starting with a musical piece, which you were supposed to do, but of course we ran late. So Nazir Ghani is a journalist based in Srinagar. He works as a senior editor with Greater Kashmir. In his over 15 years of career, he has brought many stories to limelight. He was also instrumental in popularizing art and culture, beats in Kashmir. And Ghani is passionate about the rabab, and he's a passionate rabab player and a vocalist. And he's released many Kashmiri songs, and is also, he did his best to revive the dying rabab playing art. Nazir, total respect to you for that one. And seriously, he set up the Kashmir Rabab Academy, which gives free of cost training and aspiring to rabab players. So Nazir, over to you. Before we move into the conversational part of the conversation, let's hear a small piece of the rabab since it's World Music Day.
Thank you so much, Nani. This World Music Day is a special day for me because it's my own birthday.
Happy birthday.
Yes, happy birthday, Nazir. I wished him in the morning. I forgot to do that just now.
It's my wife's birthday also.
Oh.
Happy birthday
to her also.
I'm starting with a small piece of rabab, which is a mishran of Afghani dun and Kashmiri dun.
Lovely.
क्या बात है नजीर साहब, ये जो आपने बताया कि आज आपका जन्मदिन भी है,
समझ में आ रहा है कि ये रबाब जो है वो कैसे बतन में ही आपके साथ से चल रहा था, पैदाइश से ही आपके साथ चल रहा है, और हम तो भाई सुनी सुनाई बात सुनाते हैं, लेकिन जब बड़े होते गए और इंस्ट्रूमेंट स्ट्रिंग इंस्ट्रूमेंट सुने तो समझ में आया कि ये बात वाकई में सही है कि जो स्ट्रिंग इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स होते हैं उनकी आवाज जो है इंसानी आवाज के कितने करीब होती है,
बिल्कुल,
और सीने में ऐसे उतरती है कि जैसे गालिब के शेर का तीर नीमकश, बिल्कुल न पार होता है और यहीं धसा रह जाता है। और ये जो आवाज, ये जो ध्वनि आप लोग सुन रहे हैं, आप सिर्फ ये ना सुनिएगा कि ये बस एक ऐसी आवाज है जो आपको महसूस कर रही है, पर ये वो आवाज है जो इक्कासी कर रही है, जो इस बात की भी दलील है, जो ये भी दर्शा रही है कि वो लोग जो इसको बजा रहे हैं और वो लोग जो इसको बना रहे हैं उनके दर्द का भी ये की भी इक्कासी करती है, जो वो दिहाइयों से सदियों से जो उनके ऊपर वो दर्द और वो जुल्म हो रहा है वो इसकी भी इक्कासी करती है। और यही ये जो दर्द है इसमें मजीद इजाफा हो गया कोविड आने के बाद, लॉकडाउन आने के बाद। तो एक तो पहले ही हम उसे क्या कहते हैं कि आसमान से गिरे और खजूर में अटके, वो वाला चक्कर हो गया, मंजिल हमें मिल ही नहीं पा रही है। तो दैट ब्रिंग्स अस टू व्हाट आर टुडेज यू नो डिस्कशन इज अबाउट, व्हिच इज बेसिकली अबाउट हाउ आर्टिस्ट सर्वाइव्ड पेंडेमिक, हाउ आर्टिस्ट रीइन्वेंटेड देमसेल्व्स इन पेंडेमिक। एंड आई थिंक वन ऑफ द रीजंस व्हाई वी ऑल आर हियर इज not just to talk about what we did in pandemic, what is our art form, what all we have been showcasing, but also to impress upon people that at the end of the day, we're also very human. You know, we do not request you to place us on a pedestal, and we do not request you to reduce us to a commodity and a shopping list. We are in between like you. हम भी इंसान हैं, हमारे सीने में भी दिल धड़कता है, हमको भी रोजी के चक्कर में इधर उधर जाना पड़ता है, हम भी तारीफ होती है तो खुश होते हैं, और हम भी जब हमें नजरअंदाज किया जाता है तो अफसरदा हो जाते हैं। तो आई थिंक इट इज इम्पोर्टेंट दैट टुडेज डिस्कशन बिसाइड्स टॉकिंग अबाउट हाउ वी रीइन्वेंटेड आवरसेल्व्स एंड व्हाट डिड वी डू अबाउट आवर आर्ट फॉर्म, वी ऑल्सो नीड टू टॉक अबाउट सिस्टमिक प्रॉब्लम्स, इंस्टीट्यूशनल प्रॉब्लम्स, यू नो हैविंग अ सिस्टम वेयर इट्स मोर इंक्लूसिव, इट इज मोर आर्टिस्ट सेंसिटिव, it is collaborative where all players, you know, not just the artist and the music players and the label companies, but also government, as Atul sahab bahut eloquently unhone hame ye baat samjhayi, you know, all the stakeholders need to come together and create an empathetic, inclusive kind of an ecosystem where everybody benefits from it, there is a mutual respect, and we are not reduced to commodity, you know, making, reducing people to just a commodity on a shopping list, ki bhai inka khareedein record ya na khareedein, kyunki aakhir mein aap jitna bhi qanoon bana lijiye, baat insaan ki niyat ke upar hoti hai, jaise ki Ambedkar sahab kehte the ki however good a constitution may be, it is sure to turn out bad because those who are called to work it happen to be a bad lot. To ye bahut zaruri hai ki hum सिस्टम बनाएं, कायदे कानून बनाएं, लेकिन साथ में एक नियत और एक एम्पैथी जारी रहनी चाहिए। एंड ऑन दैट नोट आई हैंड इट ओवर टू ननी, हमारे आप बिल्कुल, यू टेक ओवर द माइक, मेरा काम तो ये नहीं है,
नहीं, मैं आपको जरूर रोकूंगी यहाँ पे क्योंकि आपने बहुत वैलिड पॉइंट्स बोले हैं, एंड दिस इज व्हाट आई वांटेड बिकॉज़ दिस पैनल इज नॉट अबाउट मी आस्किंग यू अ क्वेश्चन, आई वांट एवरीबॉडी बिकॉज़ एट दिस पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम सभी लोग यहां पे सबकी पेन समझ रहे हैं, वी अंडरस्टैंड वेयर एवरीबॉडी इज, एंड यू नो इफ वी वर हैविंग दिस कन्वर्सेशन 6 मंथ्स अगो देयर वुड बी अ डिफरेंट वे ऑफ लुकिंग एट थिंग्स। 1.5 साल हो गया है पैंडेमिक का, एंड देयर स्टिल अनसर्टेनिटी लूमिंग लार्ज इन फ्रंट ऑफ अस। सो द पॉइंट इज वी आर गोइंग टू ब्रिंग अप ऑल द पॉइंट्स दैट यू हैव सेड, एंड ऑफ कोर्स लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, एज यू फिगर्ड दैट दानिश हुसैन, from his way of speaking only you would have been able to tell that he is an actor, a poet, a storyteller. In his style you can make that out, and of course he's a theater director, and he was instrumental in reviving the lost art form of dastan goi. That is how I met Danish, and pure respect, because I feel in our country today he's probably one of the best. And he later expanded this into the multilingual storytelling project called Kisse Bazi. If you haven't watched it, you must catch it. Otherwise, I'll call him for a show. Come on, guys, like this. We've got so many people sitting here. So recently, he has been applauded for his performances on screen with Netflix series. So that there, the actor bit also comes in. Called Taj Mahal 1989, Bombay Begums, and films like Me, Raksam on Z5 OTT platforms. So that was about Danish, and Danish has also made a small introduction about himself. And now I will move on to our next artist, which is Dhanashree Pandit Rai. Dhanashree ji actually needs no introduction, no introduction at all. She's one of my favorite musicians, and she is a doyen of the Chumri art form. And I will, but still share a little bit about her for those who don't know, I mean, haven't gone into depth about her. She's one of the eminent Indian classical vocalists and specializes in the Tumri and semi-classical genre of Indian music. Besides her concerts, she's widely recognized for the lively commentaries that accompany her presentations, which enlighten the audiences in her deeper mysteries of Indian music. And welcome, Dhanashree, to the panel today. And we would like to hear your thoughts and your views as well before we start off on the serious part of the conversation.
So, Nanni, I think the classical musician has understood a long while ago that he or she cannot make her livelihood from concert income in this field. So long ago, I mean, you know, all classical artists, of course, not the top rung musicians. I'm sure they have, you know, they can make a livelihood out of this. I'm saying everyone below that, you know, has already resorted to teaching or, you know, being part of a music institute or a part-time job. They are not depending totally on this income. So in that sense, in the pandemic, their work continued online. So in this field of Thumri or Khayal, the main thing is making your presence felt in the industry and getting a certain amount of recognition. So what the pandemic actually kind of aided the artist was self-publishing became a very accepted norm. You can go on your balcony and, you know, have your husband record a video of you, go up on your terrace, and nobody was laughing anymore because that's what everyone was doing, you know, from recording their morning riyas and putting it up on Facebook. That became an accepted norm. You've heard all this, no? Releasing in 3 days, be patient. Watch this space, all these things. You know, we probably made fun of other musicians. I said, oops, I'm doing it too. And the other word which was done to death was live. Live, that word live was used even when things were not happening in real time. Like a glam quotient, we started adding it. So all these things did happen, but I could reinvent myself. Like Danish said, we got that time to introspect, reinvent. So my Thumri lecture demonstration, I got rid of the word leg dem because that's such an, you know, such a boring word. So made it into narrated concert or Thumri story. So that's in a nutshell. I just wanted to say how the reinvention.
But you managed to keep the Thumri space alive, which is fantastic. And of course, the surprise item will come right at the end for the audience where we have you performing for us. And so I'm going to move on to now Sunita Bhuiya. And Sunita, again, is another artist who requires no introduction. I mean, she's been in the corporate space, she's been in the music space for the longest time. And Sunita actually is a violinist. I must give the formal protocol thing about her as well. So Sunita is a violinist and a professional and an HR professional who has broken several myths by playing Assamese folk music on the violin. And that's how we connected. I think she's just taken Assamese folk to the next level by playing it on the violin. And she's also reached out to the slums and the corporates alike, where she's been doing these specialized training, leadership workshops and programs. And I think that's what's probably kept you alive, Sunita. Would you like to share more about your experience in this period? And then we are not going to go without a small piece.
Of course. Thanks, Nani. You know, what's the point of people like us being in a panel in an event like this if we don't use our weapon of choice, you know, our voice or our instrument? So, saaz aur awaaz dono leke humko aana hai aise mahol mein, isn't it? So, good morning, everyone. And Nani, to your question, about you know what we did during the you know pandemic and how we reinvented. And Dhanashri, in her very short Thumri style story, she already said what exactly happened from live to balcony. And yes, I did the balcony. I did the balcony concert on the 23rd of March, which was the first curfew, janta ki curfew, and aap log bells or plate, jo bhi hai ghar mein wo leke aa jaiye. So I told my son that I'm not going to, we're going to play in the balcony. He said, Mom, are you crazy? Because, you know, we have been asked to do bells and plates and shankh bajane ko bole hai. I said, no, but that, this is my shankh and bell and plate and everything. But I said, are you going to play with me or not? Because you have to deal with youngsters. He's a pianist, by the way. He said, I'm very embarrassed. I don't know. But I said, I'm going to go to the balcony. If you can help me, you can. Who's going to watch you? How can they hear you? I said, I don't care. I'm going to do it for myself. So we did the balcony concert. And of course, thankfully, NDTV covered it live from 5 floors below because they couldn't come up because there was protocol that no one can go in and out of our houses. And that started the whole concept of the sound, the camera, which I had no clue of for the last 30 years of performing, because it was always dressing up, tuning the violin, thoda, you know, touch up, rehearse, tune, and go on to the stage. The whole gamut, the paraphernalia of sound, Facebook Live, save video, don't save video, and then getting into more high-end stuff like sound card to a home studio was a huge journey for me. And someone like an artist like myself was very complacent that I don't need the digital world. I don't have Instagram. I don't have a million followers. Yet I keep doing my work in my own little space. So why do I need to clutter the internet? That was always my conceited, complacent self. But I realized the power of this medium during the last 1.5 years. And like you rightly said, Nani, if not for my HR, occupation and the programs that I've been running for many years now, it's been 25 years. Basically, I'm an HR professional. Music has always been part of my hobby and my religion at home, because my mom's a violinist and she gave this to me as a gift. I realized that if I hadn't had that offering and hadn't created that a field for myself, it would have been a very difficult time for me to survive. I would have to resort to classes and music class. I'm a very bad teacher. I don't have the patience. I would have had a very difficult time to teach or to do other kind of work with my music. So I think it's a blessing. Well, that's how I managed. And from home studio to professional studio, you referred me to a very nice studio. And then all that stopped again. Things opened up. We did live shows. But things again stopped and we went back to our home studios. So just last week, I had to stream for 1,500 people on Amazon a show from home, where bandwidth became a challenge. So how do you pep up bandwidth? So every day we are learning. And that's the story.
But that's very good. That's the difference where like you all have adapted, because you were shying away from technology all this while. And everybody has now started using it as a medium. So Sunita, let's hear a small piece and then we'll move on to Abha next, and then Jan. And then we have a very impromptu piece.
You know, like they say, music is the most powerful form of inclusion, because there is no class or mass. Saat suri hai. Sa sa re ga ma pa da ni sa sa ni da pa ma ga re sa. Western note mein do re mi fa sol la ti. And all the music in the world is based on 7 notes, which everyone knows. So I would like to break this myth that there is no classical or popular. Saat suri hai. To kaun classic hai, kaun popular hai, kaun mass hai, kaun elite hai. You know, and in the time of the pandemic, we need to break myths about classes and masses, right? So this piece is a song or an invocation from the tribals of Assam, where I come from, Bodo. It's a Bodo piece which says, let's herald a new time, a new life. And it breaks into a bit of Assamese folk. It's based in one melody of Raag Bhupali. It's not the time for Bhupali, but yet I will. I'm not a singer, okay? But those lines are important.
Thank you.
Bagurumba, hey Bagurumba. Bagurumba, hey Bagurumba. Like the butterfly, they dance. Bagurumba, hey Bagurumba. Bagurumba, hey Bagurumba. Jaat nunga bula, kul nunga bula. Pagre khamnani, bamna me lagamfa. Hey lagafa lagamfa. Bagurumba, hey Bagurumba. Bagurumba, hey Bagurumba. Ganga siloni, pihiti pepare, pihiti pepare ma. Ganga siloni, pihiti pepare, pihiti pepare ma. That was the Assamese bihu.
This was beautiful. I was transported to Northeast. I was imagining that I am in. Oh my God, you're just so good, Sunita. Seriously, beautiful.
Thank you. Thank you.
I know that Ruhel might want to kill us for this, what we are doing to the session, but seriously, there's going to be so much conversation all day. It is World Music Day. We just wanted our session to be full of music so that, you know, they've had a lot of conversations. Now let's keep having some little more music and then keep throwing in conversations.
Absolutely.
Alongside.
Thank you so much, Sunita. Next time we would love to see your view dance.
Guys, wait. We are on a conference panel just now.
लेकिन वो नीता की बात सुन के मुझे ये समझ में आया कि एक मुकम्मल कंप्लीट आर्टिस्ट होने के लिए आदमी के पास उसकी साज आवाज नृत्य हाव भाव और साथ साथ वकील भी होना चाहिए. अगर आदमी वकील हो जाए इस सब के साथ तो फिर हम कंप्लीट आर्टिस्ट बन जाएंगे.
आपको फिर किसी की जरूरत नहीं. यू डोंट नीड पीपल लाइक अस टू प्रमोट और एनीथिंग. अपने आप ही सब होगा. सो आभा, यू हैड स्टेप्ड इन जस्ट नाउ एंड व्हिच इज व्हाट आई एम रियली इंटरेस्टेड इन नाउ टेकिंग द थिंग ऑन टू यू. सो बट बिफोर यू स्टार्ट, आई एम डेफिनेटली आई वुड लव टू इंट्रोड्यूस यू. Of course, I don't think you're another, but you don't need an introduction at all because people know you as the famous Hookers Bookers girl. But I totally adore you for the fact that the way you have taken Kashmiri folk and you brought it totally to the national platform. A lot of artists are doing that. I know that. But you kept the purity of the Kashmiri folk, which is what I've always respected you for. And I think a lot of us do that as well. But telling people about you. So sorry, I'm a very bad MC and I need my book to read from. But Abha Hanjura is an award-winning artist and the front woman of the eclectic folk pop band called Sophistication. A vivacious powerhouse live performer, she has stormed through the charts with her hit Kashmiri folk pop song, like I just said, Hookers Bookers, attracted it very well with audiences of all age groups, which is what is fantastic. And then she's also, and this track has also made it into the popular web series, right? Abha, you can tell us more about that one as well. And the critically acclaimed feature film, No Fathers in Kashmir. So, of course, I mean, there's a lot I know that Abha will have to share. And Abha, while you're telling us about yourself and your journey through the pandemic, and also tell us about what you saw around you and about the various musicians. And of course, definitely at the end, we do want a few lines of Hocus Pocus.
Right. So, Nani, for me, the pandemic kind of came as a big blow because it's something that kind of spilled a lot of coffee on all my plans. I was on a high. We were on an India tour and we had covered almost north, south, east, west, and then we had just like few more south shows left. And it is in the March that I was in Bombay for a show, and suddenly one after the other, I saw a cancellation of about 10 shows in like 5 days. So then I knew that something is seriously wrong, is when I realized that, okay, this is something absurd that is happening, because I have always thrived on being a live performer, and that is something that has fueled my music. Like, I have been a live performer first and then really a singer, songwriter, and therefore YouTube. All of that came later in my life. So the idea was very simple: make the money from music, from live, because I'm an independent artist and I also own my own record label. So I'm not on a record label. So for me, it was about making the money here and then putting it in the music and then going on. You know, I thought this is how it's always going to be. This is how it's always been. So I took it for granted. And then in a way, you know, it kind of shattered all of those things. But then for me, I adapted very quickly because I realized that visibility is something that we always need as artists, and we cannot stop that. So I went on to release music during the pandemic as well. I wrote songs. I had shot a music video, so I released that, and then I couldn't shoot one. So I, you know, instead of relying on a music video, I went into essentially an animated music video. And then I started really focusing a lot on streaming. I feel like as artists, I realized that we don't have to focus on just one source of income that way for us. So I have tried to reinvent in different formats now, because live for me has always been the part where the money comes from, or where I would essentially, I'm most myself when I'm on stage. So I went on to do virtual shows. Initially, I was not feeling it. I was not realizing ki kya ho raha hai, because then I realized that you should not try to replicate what you do live on a virtual platform, because that is not the space for it. So instead of doing that, I tried to recreate another show for the virtual space, which was more conversational, more intimate. And that went on to become good because, you know, in a way, I was also able to connect to audiences sitting there. I did some international shows for the people in US and all of that. There were some 500 people who tuned in, but I didn't try to make it a live experience. It was not like how you would see sophistication on stage. It was Abha and Jura with some conversation and some music, and that connected. So I think as artists, for now, we really need to know that virtual will be a different space, and that this will be a different space. We'll have to create different things. And then relying on just on other mediums and looking at all of that is something which is very important. So I put myself out there as a writer, because I'm also a songwriter. So I have ended up writing for other bands' songs, and which I suddenly realized that, oh my God, I actually enjoy it. So I started writing jingles and all of that. And I stepped into merchandising, which is something that I had not done before. I'm actually wearing the Hocus Pocus t-shirt right now.
Yes, I remember this.
This is something that I realized this song is such a big part of people's lives, and they love it so much that they're literally waking up with it and sleeping with it, some of them with their kids and all of that. So I thought, why not try merchandising? And that ended up becoming, which was a surprise for me, it really worked well. And I was like, okay, this is also great. So I think as artists, we have to open our minds to different spaces. In fact, streaming as such also is also a space where maybe we have to hope that the record industry will possibly grow, and we can look for some revenues there. And we have to essentially not try to, I think virtual will always be a different space from live. So we have to treat it like that. And eventually, as things come back to normal, so one of my friends said, when COVID is over, it's become like when we win the lottery. So we don't know when this will be over, but if it is, and God willingly, it will be soon, then, you know, this will be different, and we will possibly have hybrid models, and we'll have to rework it like that. So I don't know. I've not really understood everything, but I am just trying to reinvent every day. But सबसे मुश्किल ये है कि एक इमोशनल एस्पेक्ट ऑफ बीइंग एन आर्टिस्ट मैंने हमेशा एक लाइव एनर्जी पे थ्राइव किया है, लाइक बाय प्लेइंग लाइव, बाय मीटिंग पीपल, बाय बीइंग इन द स्टूडियो विद माय बैंड. आई हैव ऑलवेज बीन एबल टू क्रिएट. सो व्हेन दैट वेंट ऑफ, दैट इज द मेंटल एस्पेक्ट ऑफ दैट हैज बीन वेरी वेरी टफ फॉर मी टू एक्चुअली कोप विद. I'm trying hard to, you know, find ways to deal with that. But apart from that, I think, you know, if we keep ourselves sane somehow and walk through this bad phase by reinventing in whatever ways we can, then, you know, hopefully we should be able to survive. I think right now it's about survival more than thriving.
So actually we've been totally away from our subject that we were given, which was mapping the impact. But this is it. This is what it is, because the artists have been impacted hugely. Aur agar hum log isko modify nahi karenge, to impact, it's only going to get deeper and deeper. So Abha, let's quickly get two lines of Hookers Bookers from you, and then I have Jan, and then I have to introduce, I want Dazee to come on. And of course, then I'm going to throw one impromptu thing, which even both my artists over here don't know I'm going to do this to them. But that will be our ending before we show one more ending. So come on, let's quickly hear.
Yeah, I think also we're running out of time, so I'll make this very quick. I'll just sing to if you guys have not
Yes, absolutely. Do want it.
Hookus, bookus, telivan, sukus. Onnum batuk luddumbe. Hookus, bookus, telivan, sukus. Onnum batuk luddumbe. Shwas, kitch, vamano. Brahman zaran poin chokum tekisteka bani kyo. Bishtu bishtu brario khut ko van. Tor kyo vo luth babare pan. Bishtu bishtu brario khut ko van. Tor kyo vo luth babare pan. Sukha man cho khut ko taran. गोतर बीठी मार कन zoom छई गिंदा तार कन. This is basically Kashmiri folklore that has existed for
centuries. Wow, शानदार.
Thank you guys, it's been a pleasure to be here.
Can imagine what it'll be like with the with your whole band and the rhythm.
Thank you, Sunita. I can't wait for that, actually. I dream about it every night. Thank you, Atul. Thank you so much.
I think Nani disappeared.
Yes.
Now that she has disappeared, we can quickly move on to Jan. Jan, tum jaldi se apna pitara kholo. Isse pehle Nani aaye, tum apna pitara khol ke bajana shuru kar do.
I'm so sorry. I got dropped off because the power went.
She's there.
I took over the responsibility, so don't worry, Nani. I have
to open this. I'm so glad.
And now
we're I'm so glad. So are we on to Jan now?
We're on to Jan now.
Okay, great, Jan. So I think have you been introduced? So should I quickly introduce you?
Yeah, please.
Okay, so Jan Nisar Lone is a prominent music director, a playback singer, music producer, and the founder of Mumbai-based AR Music Studios and record label. Lone is known to have popularized Kashmiri music in Bollywood, and he's also credited to have introduced many voices of Kashmiri music genre. And so another voice from Kashmir that has brought Kashmir to Bombay and obviously then taken it across the country. And he's also, brought the sounds of Kashmir here, and he never compromises on food and on music. He wanted me to say that for sure. So, Lone, would you like to tell us a little bit about yourself and how you saw, sitting in the industry, the impact of the pandemic on the artists around you? Let's quickly hear this, and then we'll love to hear two lines in your voice, and then move on.
So, Nini, since everybody has just said everything about what has been happening in pandemic, so what I did, I was in Mumbai only, then I heard this is happening all around. So maine mere ghar walon ko, my family, I picked them up. So hum by road Kashmir chale aaye. Aur I had some songs ki main hamesha sochta tha ki main Kashmir chala jaunga, wahan kuch shoot karunga apne gaane. To main Kashmir aaya and I saw ki yahan pe sab tab to pehle start hi tha. To sab normal hi tha. To I started shooting my songs. But sabse achhi baat to ye thi ki main, I returned back, I think after 17 years. So isse ye hua ki pandemic se ki this pandemic brought me back to my roots, you know, in Kashmir. To jinse main bahut saalon baad jaise apne dost the, kyunki kehte hai na ki har cheez kuch humko lagta hai ki kuch bura ho gaya, लेकिन उसमें कुछ पॉजिटिविटी भी होती है, जैसे मेरे फ्रेंड सर्कल था, सबसे मिला और बड़ा मेरे लिए, मैंने इस चीज़ को बड़ा पॉजिटिवली देखा। और मुंबई में भी जब हम होते हैं, बड़े बिजी रहते हैं अपने कामों में, लेट लेट सोते हैं, तो हमने, मैं बहुत बार लेट लेट तक हम म्यूजिक बनाते रहते थे। और कभी आपको मालूम है कि पैशन ऐसा होता है कि आपको कभी सोने भी नहीं देता, लेकिन कश्मीर आने के बाद मुझे ये लगा कि भाई मैं प्रॉपर 9 बजे सो जाता हूँ, सुबह 5-6 बजे उठ जाता हूँ, पूरा मेरा लाइफस्टाइल ही चेंज हो गया। तो कुछ चीज़ें बहुत अच्छी हुई, जैसे कि दानिश जी जैसे कह रहे थे, सुनीता जी का आज, मतलब आप जैसे लोगों से आज जो मिलना हुआ, तो पेंडेमिक भी इज वन ऑफ द रीजंस। जैसे आबा जी जैसे सुना रहे थे, टुडे आई यू नो हर्ड अतुल जी आफ्टर अ लॉन्ग टाइम, अतुल जी इज वेरी डियर फ्रेंड। तो क्या हो रही, सारी चीजें बहुत अच्छी भी हुई उसमें, ऐसा नहीं है कि हम घरों में कैद हो गए, क्योंकि बेंगे कश्मीरी मैंने बहुत सालों बाद आज वापस लौटा हूँ, अपने दोस्तों से मिला हूँ, जो मैंने म्यूजिक किया था मैंने सोचा भी नहीं था इतना बड़ा इम्पैक्ट रहा होगा इसका। जो लोग मुझे देख रहे बोलते हैं हमने आपका गाना सुना है, हम आपके बहुत बड़े फैन है, क्योंकि मैं आता ही नहीं था। और मेरी खुद की कोशिश ये रही है कि अपने आप को प्रमोट करने से अच्छा, जो यंगस्टर्स है जैसे मुझे प्लेटफॉर्म नहीं मिला, मैं यहाँ से मुंबई जाना पड़ा, मैं कुछ लोगों के लिए कुछ कर पाऊँ। बहुत सारे सिंगर से मैं मिला, और मैं पहला, मतलब मैं पहला नहीं कहूँ, क्योंकि आशा जी ने भी गाने गाए हैं कश्मीरी, और मैंने नॉन कश्मीरीज को कश्मीरी गवाया। उसका रीजन ये था कि जो हमारा कश्मीरी म्यूजिक है, इफ यू माइट हैव हर्ड, ये राजी का गाना आया, उससे पहले बमरो बमरो, देन रिंद पोषमाल, शंकर एहसान लॉय ने इनको बड़ा अच्छे से प्रमोट किया, क्योंकि हमारा यहाँ का आर्ट एंड कल्चर बड़ा रिच रहा है। और सिंस दिस इज द कॉन्फ्लिक्ट जोन, कोई भी पेन जो है आर्ट की फॉर्म में उभर के आता है। तो मैंने भी बचपन से, आई वॉज इन बोर्डिंग, आई वॉज यू नो लुकिंग आफ्टर म्यूजिक, जब मैं बाहर गया तो लोगों को यही होता था कि यार इनको म्यूजिक का पता नहीं, कुछ ज्यादा ज्ञान होगा नहीं होगा। लेकिन मैंने कल भी कही यही बात कि म्यूजिक जो है ये ऊपर वाले की देन है, तो आर्टिस्ट जो है वो पैदा होते हैं, आप उनको बनाया नहीं जा सकता। कुछ लोग अगर आपको ऊपर वाले ने इस चीज से नवाजा है तो आपको थोड़ा तराशने की जरूरत होती है। इस जर्नी में क्या है, कश्मीर में मैंने बहुत सारे लोगों को इसमें 2012 से इन्वॉल्व होने के लिए मैंने देखा, जैसे आज के जो यंगस्टर्स है 2012 के बाद बहुत सारे लोग
उनका ड्रॉप हो गया है, सो जब तक वो वापस आते हैं, जस्ट टू कीप यू नो कीप ट्रैक ऑफ टाइम, सो आई क्विकली इंट्रोड्यूस नहीं रहा, हैवंट हैड अ चांस टू इंट्रोड्यूस नथिंग, आई थिंक समबडी इज माइक्रोफोन इज ऑन, मे ही इज पब्लिक, दैट कैन बी the backstage, can you all please mute me his microphone? So I'll quickly speak a little bit about Nazeer, because I do want people to know who actually Nazeer is and not just a rabab player, right? And I did introduce you bang in the beginning, so I'm going to put my book away, I don't need this anymore. So getting back to the conversation that we were having, and you know, before we go into that impromptu piece that I was saying, which is, I'm also going to tell the artists so they're mentally prepared, is going to be between Danish and Dhanashri ji. And so I'm not saying anything else, because they are the stars and they can do whatever they like to do. So they will lead to each other, because when Danish speaks and Dhanashri ji sings, I think the whole world comes to a standstill. So that is one part. But you know, seriously, what I would really like to hear from everybody is that talking about mapping the impact of the pandemic on the artists, and Danish had said a very valid point yesterday in our icebreaking session, that we basically do not have any kind of a consortium or a forum in the government. We have no representation as a forum where art, I mean, we do have, but I mean, is there a voice that's being, that the artist's voice is being heard? I would like you to bring that forward. We were talking about vaccination, we were talking about various elements, but I would like the artist to bring that out and not coming from me. So over to you, Danish.
Thanks, Nani. You know, one of the things that needs to be impressed upon is that we live in a gig economy. Danish sir, agar wapas to apna chehra dikha do, mic mute kar do, there's some disturbance in the background.
So,
we essentially live in a gig economy, and that is not just about people
at the bottom of the rung, which is like people who are working on backstage, people who are trying to promote, or people who are basically doing a front desk or a back office operation, but also artists, even senior artists. We're all are living in a gig economy. Agla show nahi mila, agli film nahi mili, to humko pata nahi check kahan se aayega hamare bank account ke andar. Up, all that has been completely wiped out. The physical gig economy has been wiped out because of the lockdown and the pandemic happening. And that puts us in a very precarious position because we are essentially living off our own savings. There is no social security network. There is no pension fund. There is no assured minimum rent income coming to us. And that puts us in a very precarious position. Uske upar turra ye ke हर आदमी चाहता है कि भाई वो जरा आप आके थोड़ा सा लाइव कर दीजिए ना, वो थोड़ा गा दीजिए, थोड़ा सा परफॉर्म कर दीजिए. और नहीं, पैसा तो नहीं है, वो रिलीफ के लिए काम हो रहा है. तो हम सोचते हैं भाई हमारा भी तो रिलीफ कर दो.
मैं वही बोलने वाली थी कि हमारी रिलीफ का क्या मतलब.
अब उस पर मुझे एक किस्सा याद आ रहा है, मैं सुनाता हूँ आपको. कि कश्मीर में एक राजा थे, उनके दरबार में एक बांसुरी वादक आए. अब बांसुरी वादक ने बहुत मधुर बांसुरी बजाई, बादशाह बहुत खुश हुए. उन्होंने कहा भाई इनको 1000 सोने की अशरफी जो है वो इनाम में दे दी जाए. अब वो घर पहुंचे, अल्लाह जाने रात में उनको नींद आई नहीं आई, इस करवट सोए उस करवट सोए. सुबह उठे, अपना जल्दी से नहा धो के साफा पहन के, कुर्ता पहन के, चटक चटक जूती पहन के, तिलक लगा के वो पहुंचे खजांची के यहाँ. और उन्होंने कहा भैया ऐसा है कि कल हम गए थे बादशाह के दरबार में, हमने बांसुरी बजाई थी, बादशाह बड़े प्रसन्न हुए थे. तो उन्होंने कहा कि 1000 सोने की अशरफी इनाम, तो लाइए हमारा इनाम लाइए. अब वो खजांची ने ऊपर से नीचे उनको देखा होगा, बट भागे से जूता निकाल के उनको दौड़ाया वहां से. वो भैया दौड़ते हुए घर आए, वो पता नहीं रात में सोए नहीं सोए, इस करवट उस करवट. सुबह अफसुरदा उठे, किसी तरह नहाया धोया साफा पहना, कुर्ता धोती सब पहन के, चटक चटक जूती, पहुंचे बादशाह के दरबार में. कह लेंगे जी वो हुजूर हम परसों आए थे, हमने वो बांसुरी बजाई थी, आप बहुत प्रसन्न हुए थे, आपने कहा था 1000 सोने की अशरफी से इनाम दे दी जाए, तो कल हम चटकवाही करने पहुंचे खजांची साहब के यहाँ. तो उन्होंने तो भैया जूता उतार उठा के मार भगा दिया हमको वहां से, कि काहे का इनाम और कैसी रॉयल्टी. तो बादशाह ये सुनकर मुस्कुराए और कहने लगे देखिए परसों आप आए थे, आपने बांसुरी बजाई, हम प्रसन्न हुए, हमने इनाम की घोषणा की, आप प्रसन्न हुए, ना आपने हमें कुछ दिया ना हमने आपको कुछ दिया, बात हो गई बराबर. तो भैया ये सीधा खेल है हम आर्टिस्ट लोगों का, कि जब हम बांसुरी बजा रहे होते हैं तब तो हमें बड़े अच्छे लग रहे होते हैं, हर तरह का प्रचार हो जाता है, घोषणा हो जाती है कि इनके लिए ये रिलीफ है, ये एड है. और जब आता है ये लेने का टाइम, तो भाई यही हो जाता है कि भाई देखिए पैसा तो नहीं है, आप
फंडरेजर है,
हमें अच्छा काम हुआ, तो इस पे ही चल रही है हमारी. तो आई थिंक इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट दैट द इनटैंजिबल क्वालिटी ऑफ द वैल्यू दैट वी आर गेटिंग इन दैट नीड्स टू बी अप्रिशिएटेड. बिकॉज एक अच्छा आर्टिस्ट, एक अच्छी परफॉर्मेंस, वो शेल्फ लाइफ बढ़ा देती है उस चीज की जो वो कर रहा है. वरना भाई रोज हर आदमी अपनी डफली बजा रहा है, किसने सुना और किसने नहीं सुना क्या पता लगता है. लेकिन एक एक अच्छी परफॉर्मेंस वो रिकॉर्ड हो गई तो वो सदियों तक चलेगी, जहां आदमी वो रेफरेंस पॉइंट बन जाएगा, वापस जाएगा, बार बार सुनेगा. और ना सिर्फ उससे महसूस होगा, वो दर्जगाह बन जाएगी. वो जो लोग हैं जो सीख रहे हैं, नए म्यूजिशियन हैं, नौमश्क लोग हैं, कॉनसियर लोग हैं, रसिक लोग हैं, वो जाएंगे और उसमें हर बार एक नया मतलब निकालेंगे. ये इंटेंजिबल वेल्थ है और इस इंटेंजिबल वेल्थ का अप्रिसिएशन होना चाहिए और एक सिस्टम होना चाहिए कि जहाँ ये लोग जो गिग इकॉनमी में काम कर रहे हैं उनके लिए एक सोशल सिक्योरिटी नेटवर्क होना चाहिए. मैं नहीं कहता हूँ कि हर आदमी का पंजीकरण होना चाहिए, क्योंकि पंजीकरण पर बहुत जोर होता है सारा. जैसे ही होगा भाई तो कल ऑल आर्टिस्ट शुड गो एंड रजिस्टर देमसेल्फ. अरे भाई वो पंजीकरण के चक्कर में ना पड़िए. आज की दुनिया में बड़े आराम से आप ये पता लगा सकते हैं कौन आर्टिस्ट है कौन नहीं आर्टिस्ट है. कोई आर्टिस्ट जो है वो एक दो अपना क्रेडिबल रेफरेंस लेके आए, उसको खंदा पेशानी से एक्सेप्ट कीजिए और उसको साहब जो उसकी मदद है उसकी कीजिए और उसको उसके हाल पे छोड़ दीजिए. ज्यादा उस पर बंदिशें ना लगाइए, क्योंकि बंदिश जब लगेगी तो वो बंदिश में ऐसी बंदिश गा देगा कि आपके तोते उड़ जाएंगे. तो ये सिर्फ मेरा इतना कहना है. ननी प्लीज, मैं ज्यादा वक्त नहीं लेना चाहता. धनश्री
जी कहिए कहिए.
ये मेरा कहना है. और कितना वक्त है हमारे पास भाई? देखिए हम लोग 25 मिनट लेट आए,
हमारे पास
45 का वादा था और नितिन साहब 11:11 पे चिल्लाए थे, ग्यारह ग्यारह हो रहा है, हम सब छब्बीस मिनट हम लोग लेट हैं, तो
हमारे पास दस मिनट अभी और हैं, लेकिन हमारे को दो परफॉर्मेंसेस अभी बीच में डालनी है।
अच्छा तो मैं आपको एक प्रश्न सुना देता हूँ, उसके बाद फिर धनश्री जी हैं, आप हैं, बाकी सब लोग हैं। तो
नज्म बोल रहे हैं, आपने इसी नज्म से उठाना है।
हाँ, ये मैं आपको नज्म सुनाता हूँ। ये नून मीम राशिद साहब की नज्म है, बहुत बड़े शायर थे, लाइक बेसिकली फाउंडर ऑफ द मॉडर्न उर्दू पोएट्री। और इस नज्म का उन्वान है अंधा कबाड़ी, द ब्लाइंड जंक सेलर। अब इसमें थोड़े उर्दू के अल्फाज आएंगे जो मुश्किल हैं, मैं बीच बीच में उसे ग्लॉस करूंगा, लेकिन आप जो है वो बस कहानी का सिरा पकड़े रहिए, आप पहुंच जाएंगे। क्योंकि हम सब जो हैं, चाहे हम आर्टिस्ट हों, चाहे हम म्यूजिक कंपनीज हों, चाहे हम फिल्म कंपनीज हों, चाहे सरकार क्यों ना हो, हम सब ख्वाब बेच रहे हैं। तो ये एक ख्वाब बेचने वाले अंधे कबाड़ी की कहानी है। शहर के गोशों में है ताश कस्ता सरबुरीदा ख्वाब, गोशा मैंने नुक्स कॉर्नर क्रैनी, पाशकस्ता डिफीटेड फीट, सरबुरीदा हेडलेस ख्वाब, आप सब समझते हैं ड्रीम्स। अब आप नज्म पे तवज्जो दीजिए। शहर के गोशों में है पाशकस्ता सरबुरीदा ख्वाब, जिनसे शहर वाले बेखबर, घूमता हूं रोज और शब शहर के गोशों में कि इनको जमा कर लूं, दिल की भट्टी में तपाऊं जिससे छुट जाए पुराना मैल, इनके दस्त पा फिर से उभर आए, चमक उठें लबो रुखसार गर्दन, जैसे नौ आरास्ता दूल्हों के दिल की हसरतें, फिर से इन ख्वाबों को समत रह मिले। ख्वाब ले लो ख्वाब, सुबह होते ही चौक पे जाकर लगाता हूं सदा, ख्वाब असली हैं या नकली, यूं परखते हैं कि जैसे इनसे बढ़कर ख्वाबदां कोई ना हो, ख्वाबगर मैं भी नहीं, सूरत गरे सानी हूं बस, हाँ मगर मेरी मईशत का सहारा ख्वाब है। शाम हो जाती है, मैं फिर से लगाता हूं सदा, मुफ्त ले लो मुफ्त ये सोने के ख्वाब,
वाह वाह वाह,
मुफ्त सुनकर और डर जाते हैं लोग, चुपके से डर जाते हैं लोग, देखो ये मुफ्त कहता है, कोई इसमें धोखा ना हो, कोई शोभदा पिन्हा ना हो, शोभदा मैंने जादू, कोई इसमें धोखा ना हो, कोई शोभदा पिन्हा ना हो, घर पहुंचकर टूट जाएं या पिघल जाएं ये ख्वाब, भक्त से कहीं उड़ जाएं या हम पे कोई सहर कर दे ये ख्वाब, जी नहीं किस काम के ऐसे कबाड़ी के ये ख्वाब, ऐसे नाबीना कबाड़ी के ये ख्वाब। रात हो जाती है, ख्वाबों के पुलिंदे सर पे रख के मुंह बिसोड़े घर को लौटता हूं और रात भर फिर बड़बड़ाता हूं, इनके दाम इनके दाम शुक्रिया, थैंक यू,
वाओ, दिस वाज ब्यूटीफुल,
थैंक यू सो मच,
आई गॉट गूज बम्स यार, सीरियसली,
सेम हियर, सेम हियर,
यूटिलाइजिंग द होल थिंग, सो धनाश्री जी, लीडिंग फ्रॉम हियर, लेट्स हियर अ स्मॉल पीस फ्रॉम यू एंड देन वी कम टू नज़ीर।
ओके, सो धन्नी, आई वांटेड टू जस्ट डू अ लिटिल, यू नो, द मेन क्रक्स ऑफ ठुमरी, वेयर यू से वन लाइन in different ways to project different emotions. So here the Naika is saying a very simple thing, more saiya nahi aaye, mora jiyara jalaye, my beloved hasn't come and my heart is burning. And now just see the different ways in which you can, first she is mildly irritated, more saiya nahi aaye ram, मोरे सैया नहीं आए राम मोरा जियरा जला. नाउ शी इज रियली गेटिंग वरीड. आई डोंट थिंक ही इज कमिंग. मोरे सैया नहीं आए मोरा jiyara jalai. Now she's a little hopeful. I think he's there somewhere on the horizon. Mure saiya nahi aaye mure saiya nahi aaye mura jiyara jalai. She's angry. More saiya nahi aaye more saiya nahi aaye mora jiyara jalai. And finally the despair. She knows he's not going to come. मोरे सैया नहीं आए मोरे सैया नहीं आए मोरा राम जियरा जला मोरा जियरा जला. So that was just the crux of, you know.
Wow. So short and so nice.
ये तो आपने धनश्री जी वैसे ही किया है. साड़ी का पल्लू दिखा दिया, साड़ी नहीं दिखाई पूरी.
अब देखिए ऐसा है, कॉन्फ्रेंस के ऊपर आपको पल्लू ही दिखाना जरूरी है, क्योंकि साड़ी के लिए आपको एफर्ट करना पड़ेगा. नहीं, साड़ी के लिए एफर्ट कीजिए. अभी तो हमने बात किया है कि फ्री म्यूजिक नहीं देंगे, अभी हमने आपको स्नीक्स दी है. और इससे ज्यादा चाहिए तो आप आर्टिस्ट से कांटेक्ट कीजिए, तो सब कुछ मिलेगा आपको.
ये पैगाम उन लोगों के लिए जो सुन रहे हैं.
यस एग्जैक्टली. आर्टिस्ट टू आर्टिस्ट वी आर हैप्पी टू शेयर फॉर विद गुडविल, बट फॉर पीपल आउटसाइड द आर्टिस्ट फ्रेटर्निटी इट हैज टू बी,
देयर हैज टू बी वैल्यू. वी आर वेरी हैप्पी टू शेयर द लव. या वी आर वेरी हैप्पी टू शेयर द लव. वी डेफिनेटली नीड दैट. डेफिनेटली सो वी नीड टू रिस्पेक्ट द आर्टिस्ट. वी नीड टू रिस्पेक्ट द आर्ट फॉर्म्स बिकॉज they are the ones that give us joy, they are the ones that give us happiness. So Nazir, over to you. We would like to hear from you the status of the artist and the impact of the pandemic in Kashmir, because you are like right embedded there, and being a journalist also you obviously are researching a lot more. So we would definitely like to hear from you. Nazir, over to you. Nazir is suddenly frozen.
Yeah, frozen.
Abhi tak he was okay. He's suddenly frozen. Okay, so while Nazir comes back, Jan, would you like to quickly sing two lines? Because
yeah,
after
I would,
so
I would like to sing something from Baba Bulle Shah, synonymous to what Dhanashri Ji was singing. Asi nazuk dil de lok haan sada dil na yaad dukhaya kar ना झूठे वादे किता करना झूठियां कस माखा कर तेरी याद दे विच में मर जासा मैनू इन्ना याद न आया कर तेरी याद दे विच में मर जासा मैनू वल वल ना आजमाया कर हाँ मैनू वल वल ना आजमाया कर मंदिर डा दे मस्जिद डा दे जो कुछ डेना है पर किसे दा दिल ना डावी रब दिला विच रे जाए. थैंक यू सो मच.
वाह वाह वाह, बहुत उम्दा, बहुत उम्दा,
बहुत खूबसूरत, बहुत ही खूबसूरत.
और दानी जी का, दानी जी की मैंने जुबान सुनी उर्दू दानी जी के लिए यह है कि हवा बनकर मेरे पास आ मैं तुम्हें खुशबू बना दूंगा, हवा बनकर मेरे पास आ मैं तुम्हें खुशबू बना दूंगा, तुम कोई भी जुबान हो मैं तुम्हें उर्दू बना दूंगा।
वाह वाह, उस पे मैं अपनी तरफ से गालिब का शेर पढ़ता हूँ कि तेरे तौसन को सबा बांधते हैं, तौसन कहते हैं वाइल्ड अनटेम्ड हॉर्स को, सबा कहते हैं ब्रीज को, कि तेरे तौसन को सबा बांधते हैं हम भी मजमून की हवा बांधते हैं।
Not just the artists, but the whole population got, you know, they were forced to remain indoors. But this population was highly affected. And before that also, you know, we have had a lot of hartals, curfews and all. So I have personally met a lot of artists who have either shifted to, मैंने एक artist को देखा बहुत अच्छा singer था. So I saw him कि he is selling fruits in one of the markets. तो मैंने कहा क्यों ऐसा क्यों किया? कहा कि पिछले 8 महीने में एक बुकिंग मिली थी उसको और वो भी उसमें उसने 4,000 कमाया था। तो he said कि I won't be able to, you know, sustain on this, so I kind of tried to switch over. And such stories where you have top grade, a top artist who used to perform in Radio Kashmir, All India Radio now, and Doordarshan or Cultural Academy, they are now, you know, indoors. I mean, उनका कोई काम ही नहीं है। No bookings, no concert तो होता ही नहीं है कश्मीर। There's no culture of concerts in Kashmir. Second, a mega concert happens, it happens with some contours. There are a lot of factors behind. So artist fraternity overall is affected, and their story is not so, you know, revealing and interesting. जो जैसे वो महसूस करते हैं लोगों को वैसी उनकी खुद की story नहीं है. And very recently, जब ये pandemic हुआ, तो department of this academy, cultural academy, one of the officers there, he was very culture sensitive. He took an initiative of, you know, launching online concerts. So he booked these artists. So I started doing story, and तो उसके बाद क्या हुआ, वो जो artists थे, कुछ artists को पता ही नहीं था कि हमें login कैसे करना है, because हमारे आपके जो local ये जो artists login कैसे करें, तो उनका वो भी चला गया बेचारों का, तो उसमें भी chunk of artists got, you know, benefit. And फिर ये आपका जो है recently सारे जो लोग हैं की vaccination की गई, हर एक जो chunk of population उनका ध्यान रखा गया, लेकिन artists जो थे they were the people who had to send out statements every day that
ओ नजीर आपका म्यूट पे हो गया है, नजीर आपका म्यूट पे हो गया है जी।
Am I audible?
Yeah.
So these are certain, you know, certain stories जहाँ पे हमें लगता है कि we are not able to, you know, celebrate and, you know, acknowledge the contribution of our own artists. So उसमें story is really bad. I would really like to just sing one जो एक हमारे सिंगर थे यहाँ पे विजय मल्ला करके, उनका एक गाना जो रिसेंटली हमने कहीं पे गाया था तो बहुत अच्छा लगा था। दैट इज गोइंग टू बी अ डेडिकेशन टू ऑल दीज आर्टिस्ट जो सफर कर रहे हैं, जिन्होंने बहुत कुछ सहा है हमारे इसमें, तो उनके लिए एक डेडिकेशन है
जी।
नद्राव नचने हवस का नचुल गुबार बलो, नद्राव नचने हवस का नचुल गुबार बलो, चरस यो हस्ते वन तेरा ये थई बहार वालों त्यो कपर सलाहत नजर गया मत्यो कप छलव नजर गया मे बुत गुलाल दिल मे बुत गुलाल दिल तोत वावनार वालो नदाव नचनी हवस का तो आफ्टर दिस डेडिकेशन देयर इज वन मोर यू नो एस्पेक्ट दैट इज जो हमारे थिएटर आर्टिस्ट हैं थिएटर्स आर क्लोज नाउ आपका सिनेमा पोस्ट 90 खत्म हो गया देयर इज नो एंटरटेनमेंट हैपनिंग आपकी जो आर्टिस्ट इंडस्ट्री है इट इज जस्ट लिविंग फ्रॉम हैंड टू माउथ अगर इस सुबह निकलेंगे आप देखेंगे जो यहाँ पे एक आर्टिस्ट एक जगह है वहां पे ये देखते हैं तो यू विल फाइंड देम इधर सिपिंग चाय फॉर द होल डे और डिस्कसिंग देयर लाइफ स्टोरीज रिसेंटली आई डिड वन फुल पेज फीचर ऑन हाउ ड्रीम्स हैव बीन शैटर्ड बाय द करंट सिचुएशन इन कश्मीर एंड हाउ आर्टिस्ट आर स्विचिंग ओवर टू अदर यू नो प्रोफेशन और अदर जॉब्स सो दैट इज द करंट सिचुएशन राइट नाउ
True. So I'm sorry I'm butting in because I think we've overshot our time also and the entire thing will get delayed. So we had actually a very beautiful last piece to be played, but I think that will probably be shared with the audiences later. We will not be able to do it just now as part of our panel, which is actually to prove how a Thumri art, it was a chant by Dhanashri ji and a combination with Dhanashri ji and Merlin, which released and published by Atul Churamani, who was with us, a very dear friend, and the Turnkey Music Publishing. So that is sitting on YouTube. So we'll be very happy to share that video. So all I want to say is that the take home from here, from our session is, I will not ask everybody to give that one last word because we don't have the time. But the take home really is that do whatever you can. Just don't lose hope. Don't lose confidence in yourselves. The times are uncertain. We ourselves don't know where
Nani is dropping. So Mithun, you need to take over, I guess.
Thank you, Nani, for that absolute great conversation and that also is musical. You see that how it's breaking.
Not only I'm hearing it like that. She has gone on a problem.
Third wave is coming. Probably it's coming. Protect ourselves and we meet again.
So she comes with the third wave.
Yes, she does. I quickly want to wrap this up. I don't know much of Kashmiri, but you know, all I want to say is. Vare Vare. I think that session was a Vare Vare session. Every bit of it. Thank you from everyone.
Vare Vare is everything is fine. Everything is fine.
Yes, everything is fine. That's right. Everything is fine, right? In this situation. So thank you all. I wish you all a World Music Day, a great Yoga International Day as well. Spread the love, spread the message. I loved every bit of the musical session that you all had. Thank you for your time. Very soon we connect together. But for now, stay home, stay safe, and always bless, always smile and shine. And Danishji, I'm a big fan of your acting, sir.
Thank you, Mithun. Thank you.
And Abha and everyone else, thank you so much. God bless you all.
Thanks, everybody.
Nani, you're a rock star. Remember that. You're the best MC.
Thanks, Nani, for everything. Thanks, Ruhil.
Thank you. I don't know if I'm visible, but thank you, everyone, for everything.
Yes, I love listening to
you. I don't know if I'm audible and visible, but thank you, everyone.
Thank you so much. Thanks, everyone, for this wonderful session.
Thank you, Nazir, for the beautiful.
Thank you all.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. And Janasar Bhai, Shukran.